to be really young. To be young means to be energetic, means to be open. Oscar Wilde said, youth is lost on the young. इसका मतलब समझते हैं कि हम सिर्फ शरीर से युवा हो जाते हैं, मन हमारा या तो बच्चे जैसा रह जाता है या फिर सीधे बुढ़ापे में बाईपास लेके भी पहुंच जाता है. Is it, do we really have to go too far to inquire why am I living like this? और why की बात भी पीछे आती है. पहले तो आता है कि do I know how I am living? मैं अगर इंजीनियरिंग कर रहा हूं तो क्यों कर रहा हूं? मैं किसी भी क्लास में बैठता हूं तो हमेशा बोर्ड क्यों महसूस करता रहता हूं? इस बात को हम आप खोल के देख पाते हैं क्या कि हमारे तरीके क्या है जीने के, कि जिंदगी मेरी कैसी जा रही है, मेरी हड्डी या किसी और के इशारों पर नाच रही है? कहां जाना है? कुछ पढ़ने तो नहीं जाना, लाइब्रेरी तो नहीं जाना? हाउ एम आई लिविंग, ये देखने के लिए बस देख ही तो लेना है ना अपने आप को. सेकेंड ईयर में हूं, आप में से बहुत लोग अभी से चिंता में होंगे कि तुम्हारी नौकरी लगेगी कि नहीं लगेगी. ऑलवेज buffeted by doubts, queries, insecurities, confusions. मैं जहां हूं वहां कभी होता नहीं. आधा बंधन अतीत का रहता है और बाकी भविष्य का. पहले देखिए तो हम कि हम कैसे जी रहे हैं. जब हम ये देखेंगे तब एक एहसास होगा दैट लाइफ प्रेशियस, आई एम इंपॉर्टेंट एंड इट कैन नॉट बी वेस्टेड अवे लाइक दिस. देयर मस्ट बी समथिंग मोर टू लाइफ. बट दैट होलनेस, दैट कंप्लीटनेस विच लाइफ डिजर्व्स, दैट यू कैन गिव टू इट ओनली व्हेन यू फर्स्ट रियलाइज द इनकम्प्लीट, द फ्रेगमेंटेड, द डिवाइडेड ways in which we are living. First, you become sensitive to your own suffering. Only then there is a possibility to go beyond it and live a rich, full, joyful life, an energetic life. अगर मैं अभी आपका यहाँ पे recording कर रहा है, अगर मैं इनसे कहूँ कि इनके मैं पीछे का record कर लूँ और वो recording मैं आपको दिखाऊँ और फिर मैं आपसे पूछूँ कि भूल जाइए कि आप मुझे बताइए बाबी कि क्या ये लोग आपको joyful लग रहे हैं, तो आप खुद ही कहेंगे कि नहीं ये बेचारे बड़े मायूस से लग रहे हैं, इनके साथ क्या हो गया है, इनके साथ ऐसा क्या हो गया है जो ये इस गति को आ गए, ये कहीं से भी यंग एनर्जेटिक लोग लग नहीं रहे, इनका बिल्कुल भी ऐसा नहीं लग रहा है कि इनमें कुछ हाथ है. पहले तो बात को समझे तो बट वी आर बिकम सो अकस्टम्ड टू अवर ओन मिजरी that we have no realization, no sensitivity left to ourselves. My request to you is become a little more sensitive to yourself. Become a little more sensitive to yourself. Don't be so cruel. We are utterly cruel towards ourselves. We do not even know how we are feeling. Even our so-called emotions are nothing but conditioned reactions. Become a little more sensitive, huh? Become a little more responsive towards yourself. Yes, would you? Yes, let me have one last person speak. Obviously, you are not speaking, I am extracting something out of you. But still, is there anybody who really volunteer and want to say something? Yes.
So there's a question in your mind. It's about expectations. Expectations, personal expectations, we at times describe the other expectations. And if we fail, then we are the only one for them. No one asks us what's our expectations from them. No one asks what they should expect from us. What just every time we keep comparing to each other with expectations. Why these expectations are so much
better? These, what's your name?
Me.
Even these expectations are a part of a trade-off that we have agreed to. These are part of a business transaction that has your approval. These are not expectations. This I would rather call as extracting my pound of flesh. This I would rather call as extracting my pound of flesh. You see, we know how people are, we know how society is, we know how we are, we know how our families are. If we give just 100 rupees to somebody, we want it back, right? We want it back, correct? Or we want some return of some kind, right? Now somebody who is spending lakhs and lakhs upon you, you are taking that money from him, right? As adults, and you are not kids, 3 or 4 years old. You are all adults. If you are taking lakhs and lakhs from somebody, rest assured, he will extract it back from you. If not in cash, then in time. Just to maintain a facade of relationship, the fellow may not ask you to return the money in cash, but then it will have to be returned in some way or the other. It will have to be returned in some way or the other. And hence, you are pressurized to follow others' expectations. Nobody, can the man on the road pressurize you? Can just anybody come and pressurize you? No. Only the one to whom you have surrendered by way of obligation, only he can pressurize you. I'm very surprised. My campus, and I happen to have been at two of the most prominent educational institutions in this country, more than half the students were studying on education loan. Not that their parents were beggars, not that they really desperately needed to take a loan, but they had taken a loan because they wanted to remain free. And when I visit colleges of your university, I do not find many students on education loan. How many on education loan here? One. Now, is it any wonder that when you are taking lakhs and lakhs and lakhs from a person, that person automatically now gets the right to decide your future? When he's giving you so much, doesn't he now get the right to have a decisive say in your future? Why are you doing that? All of you are adults and we all know how much workload is there in your university. It is nothing, absolutely nothing. But then you would go and beg for pocket money. What will you do? Some small work, some jobs, and earn some stuff for yourself, at least for your daily expenditure. And then you claim that we are being pressurized. Others think that we are slaves and we follow their expectations. You are the one who is making yourself a slave. Nobody can make you a slave without your consent. You are giving your consent to becoming a slave. You withdraw your consent and you are free. But withdrawing that consent would mean moving out of your comfort zone. Would mean that you do not surrender your time after college hours. Would mean that you actually go work and earn something for yourself. Are you prepared? Freedom does not come free. Freedom has to be earned. Are you prepared to earn your freedom? Freedom from expectations, freedom from obligations. Are you prepared to earn your freedom? I do not hear anything from you. You are not at all prepared to earn your freedom. And hence you will remain slaves. You have chosen to remain slaves. Yeah. Nobody has imposed slavery upon you. The day you decide, the day you see that I am free and I deserve a free life, you will actually be free. But first, let that realization come.